Hi, I'm Andrew Wood. I run the Andrew Wood Acting Studio in Los Angeles. In the classes that I teach, I share with my students the extraordinary approach to acting that I encountered in the MFA directing program at the Yale School of Drama. When someone's interested in joining my class, I invite them to meet me for coffee. This is a chance for me to tell prospective students about the class, how it works, what they can expect, workload, answer any questions that they have. And it's also an opportunity for me to hear a bit about what they've experienced, projects that they've done, and also the prior training experiences that they've had, if any. There are a few refrains that I hear about people's training experiences. They come up again and again. Some people say they're in classes where they get told that what they do is awesome and that they should be working. They're not really given any constructive criticism that will help them to get better at what they're doing. Other people find themselves in classes where the teacher has clear favorites and the teacher fixates on those people and everyone else has to kind of fend for themselves. Or they are given coaching, but there's no overarching approach or technique, so the students tend to feel that what they're being asked to do is kind of arbitrary. Or the coaching is so brief that there's no real opportunity to get into the scene and the character in depth and look at how the student has thought about those things, how they've approached those things, and what's going on in the execution of the scene. I'm happy to tell you that at Andrew Wood Acting Studio, none of those things are the case. I'm deeply committed to every student who takes my class, and I'm deeply committed to sharing, as I said, this powerful approach, technique, methodology, whatever you want to call it, that I encountered at the Yale School of Drama. In its broad outlines, the approach has three phases. The first is about extracting what we need from the text, the salient, significant, decisive facts of the character's situation. Some of those facts are pretty obvious and others are kind of hiding in plain sight. And so we need to develop skill and we need to practice spotting those things. Once we've extracted those things from the text, then we need to develop a point of view about them. What's the best way that we can look at the character's situation to give the actor the best possible chance of doing truly compelling work? The goal is that the actor becomes viscerally activated, activated at the gut level. And how the actor talks to himself or herself about what's going on in the scene, what the character is up against, has everything to do with whether or not that visceral activation shows up. So once we've extracted what we need from the text and we've found the best possible framing that we can, then it becomes about execution. It becomes about learning to pursue the priorities of the character. It becomes about playing to win, about confronting and insisting, and dealing with what comes from the scene partner. Those are sort of the broad outlines of the approach. There's more to it than that, but I can say that in the 12 years that I've been teaching this approach, I've seen that students who come to class ready to learn new things and apply themselves consistently, that this approach can make a significant difference in their work over a pretty short period of time and can be truly transformative when it's studied over a longer period of time. So I want to invite you to email me now, act better, what you want to learn how to do in the class, actbetter@andrewwoodla.com. Let's set up a time, have coffee. I'll tell you more about what it's all about and we can take it from there. I hope to hear from you.